Last year, the World Food Programme embarked on the Food Prioritization Assistance Programme among the refugee communities. The programme saw the food rations refugees were receiving from the international organization reduced. Under this programme, the refugees were categorized under three categories. The first category is meant to receive 60% of the food assistance, the second category 40%, while the third category is not supposed to receive any food assistance. The food cuts from the World Food Programme left a number of refugees in the settlement communities stuck since they are no longer receiving any food or the food they are receiving is no longer enough for them and their families.
We are refugees.
Anajua tuko wakimbizi.
But we want to see how we can be self-reliant. We don't want to be depending on the aid we are given, but also we want to start becoming self-reliant in our homes.
Now, refugees from Ramwanja settlement camp, mainly the youth, decided to venture into commercial agriculture with an aim of earning income and also secure food for their households.
Had the tractor to help us, so and now we are harvesting. Actually, there was some challenges because we came from far, but now we have reached our goals.
According to Charles Kashindi, a member of the Agriculture Development Association, venturing into agriculture will help refugees overcome the challenges created by the shortages of food following the food cuts from World Food Programme.
Alice, it helps me to change my mindset because my mindset was to depend on UNHCR, World Food Programme, or other partners who have been helping refugees food. But after finding that I'm not accessing food, monthly ration, so this project, it helps me or to be out of the ration month, it helps me to change my mindset.
With support from AgriFarm Uganda, the youth refugees were able to secure a 10-acre land and farm inputs on credit so that they could pay back after harvest. Agnes Mbawazi, the executive director, AgriFarm Uganda, says 25 million shillings project is a demonstration plot to show other refugees in the refugee communities they can engage in agriculture and get food while the surplus is sold.
But what we want to see is to see young people able to get food in the refugee community and also have a surplus to sell and get an income.
Food would be attractive to the youth because they don't have to incur capital overhead.
Mbawazi says the project will enable the refugees to change their perspective on how they look at things other than relying on donors for donations.
This maize project, we believe, is going to change their perspective of looking at things, and we believe that they will be able, whatever they will harvest, they'll be happy because they'll have food and then some money.
Mohammed Sharif, the executive director from Kabarole Research and Resource Center, Uganda, says financial institutions should be encouraged to support these refugees so that their model can continue to thrive in the refugee communities.
We can also engage them. This time is going to be the youth go to the financials and say, well, I think we have a model that works.
However, it was also discovered that these refugees are not only facing food cuts, but also the acreage of land they used to get has also been cut. With the numbers of refugees increasing annually, the acreage of land given to them was reduced from 1 acre to a quarter acre. Peter Bwayaka from the World Food Programme says the programme will also help in solving this challenge.
With AgriFarm is let the refugees cultivate, get food, which they can supplement what World Food and other donor agencies are giving them. At the same time, get extra to sell.
Uganda hosts over 1.5 million refugees. Most of the refugees in the country come from South Sudan, Democratic Republic of Congo, Somalia and Burundi. Report compiled by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.